Emañ an ovan d'ur geriad en gozh besavet ga klaskerien naour en nantekvet kanvet. Hag ar men glechou o deus an istori ranman, bevoen ar mendiaze ma voe saet stat Colorado varnañ. En nantek bet kanvet ez eus deredet ur mor adud da Colorado ga d'ur pal kavout daour. Hag amañ e Victor ez eus bet birvil forz pegemen. Marc Gregory zo c'hort oz ar-hanon an istor ur lec'hel nez ur bern traoù da gontadin divar ben an ar-han braz hag ar glaskerien aour. Hi Marc, how are you doing?
Good morning.
Morning.
Good to see you.
How are you?
I'm doing just fine. And yourself?
Perfect.
Good, good. Fine, it's okay.
Oh, yes.
Okay, great. Great. This is just outside of Victor, known as the City of Gold Mines. Oh. This volcanic caldera that is now the modern mine site, at one time had 550 gold claims on it. A lot of those never produced a nickel. You know, never produced. And there are others that got that were just incredibly, incredibly rich. You were just the luck of the draw. Prior to the gold rush, 15 people lived in this entire district, cattle ranchers. That's all this was cattle country. One of the ranchers, Bob Womack, was the discoverer of the first gold strike. Mm-hmm. Bob, unfortunately, was just known as a drunken cowboy. And nobody believed there was gold up here. He would get his monthly pay, go down to Colorado Springs, blow it in the saloons, but he always took ore samples with him down to the assayers. Once again, nobody believed there was gold here. One day, out of boredom, one of the assayers took Bob's sample out of the trash can that he'd thrown away earlier in the day, sampling it, realizing it was the richest gold ore he'd ever seen. That was it. The rush was on.
Oh, yeah.
In less than 10 years, 55,000 people filled up this district.
And did one of them become a millionaire?
Oh, yeah, there was about 30 of them actually became millionaires. Now, at the time, in the beginning, everyone was concentrated up north at Cripple Creek looking for gold. Stratton, realizing it was a caldera, he thought, well, maybe there's better strikes down here in the south end. Coming down here on horseback, he found surface gold. Gold from volcanic activity came up molten and then solidified on the surface of the earth. 30 feet long, probably 10 feet wide, probably another 20 feet deep. Imagine that being solid gold. That's what he found. The Strong Mine, which is just around the corner, Samuel Strong, he come up here hearing about the gold rush. And he saw Stratton coming over here on horseback, and he followed him.
Oh.
When he saw Stratton strike his claim, he stuck a claim right next to him, becoming a millionaire instantly overnight. Unfortunately, he was just horrible with his money. He was a womanizer, a drunkard. Later on in time, that was about maybe 10 years after he struck it rich, he had to borrow $10 from a bartender in Cripple Creek to cover a gambling debt, and he wouldn't pay it back. One time he was in that very bar, the bartender said, hey, I want my money back, you gotta pay me. And Strong, being the idiot that he was, thought he would threaten him, pull a gun out of his pocket and threaten him. Tenor had a shotgun under the bar, shot him point blank in the forehead and killing him.
Finished.
And he was acquitted because Strong pulled the gun first.
Ouspen triwermil mengleus dilezet hag aver en deiachio e Colorado. Aour ve just, med achan ie, glau hag uranium goude. Mirdi ar mengleuchou e Colorado Springs a gont dibaoe anterkan la ar bajenman deus istor ar stad. An doktor, Rick Sowers a zo un deus ar gwellar benigourien a zo war an ten aour e Colorado e pen ur mir diema. Diskouez ar aidom mekanikou a gendalc d'avon en dro an aga ver mui e lec'ha le bet.
Hi, good morning. Good morning.
Ur wirs plus jaden en amzer dremé enet. À Maréo Cris Armenglochou.
When this museum was founded in 1970, our founder Fred Fair wanted engines and machines instead of just rusty equipment that most mining museums have, and so we have a little bit of everything in here. This is a 34-ton George Corliss steam engine built in Providence, Rhode Island. It was active until 1970. So when this building was built, this went in first. When the flywheel is spinning, this is spinning at a minimum of 60 revolutions a minute. So one complete circle every second. In the late 19th, early 20th centuries, most miners were making $3 for an 8-hour day. And the big mining companies, when they were making money, they had 3 8-hour shifts, working 24 hours a day, 6 days a week.
Rag ar vue ar menglechou a va di eskenan. Emil naurantri e sa va zarzou labour vi kondisyon nou labour gwella. Pemzek miz e padas. Gouard broad el stad Colorado a voe galvet gant ar gouarner e neb a labourerien, laket ar stad din dan lezen ar brezel a ro ed ar galout d'ar general Sherman Bell. Meur a viche eror a voe lahet a daouran syndikal ur harzet a kaset kuit diouz ar vro.
Miners could get blown up accidentally underground, have rocks fall on them, step in the holes. It was a dangerous occupation.
Emil Nauchan Pevarzeg et Ludlo din dan Colorado Springs et ten nazar guard broardel var familiou menglezerien et discroglarbour. Gant mindraie rezet e voe tennet war ur c'hamm e l'er mavain o jom, un ugen bennag a dud a voe lachet, menglezerien, merchet a bugale en o zouez. Berch a zavas, a goude a lazard egman e voe kroget davad da velad a rondisyon ou labour en menglechou.
Capital Price Gold Mine in Georgetown. Cet ur vengleuz m'ave tenet aour dalc'hmañ diboe mileizkant triugen. Disken omta, 300 met din dan zouar, da bikamein, da heulia gwezenou, a piouar, da gavout an tanzor.
Greg a Daniela a un cho a ran an endroiad.
How you doing?
Welcome to Capital Price.
Nice. Nice to meet you.
We'll have to head in farther.
Yes, okay.
Et triwer kan seiz a triugen va bedigoret ar mengleuz kan ar vreudeur Griffiths.
You find the gold in the creeks, that's fortunate, but it plays out really fast. So in the first couple years, it's gone. And then you got to get to the primary source where you're getting into the mountains and trying to extract it out of here. Oh, in the rocks. So this is hard rock mining.
Greg en eus eritet al l'air digan edut.
This is the orange colors, that's the vein. So you can see like more of the vein. And the vein keeps going, as you guys see. They keep going all the way above the ground.
Seitek Gwaziana da Zobekave der Mengleus.
That's a beautiful piece of these veins.
Produit de 2 million oiseaux laharou, otena aour, achan, plom, zinc, aquaeor.
So right back at that.
Yeah?
No. Just like that.
A dolioù pik e veze distaget ar or.
Well, I'm not really good as...
Well,
as
8 more hours of this and your shift's over.
Ok, doare ou efe du sa razo.
It is rather loud. You'll see it automates it.
Dan vetarz ave la keden toul agred e ar jeu.
Now we have to crush the ore to get the minerals out.
Mm-hmm.
This is the result of freshening the ore.
Bremañ e ranc er sila a c'hail dra liet evit tenna aour a c'hant pe gwezhañ.
And this all came from this fresh ore from back there. So that is definitely like fascinating, right? We have these concentrates collected here in this ice cream.
Oh yeah, you can see it.
Oh yeah.
Takes a lot of that to get some gold out of it. But that's where it is.
Vel just e rankoar mineralou poner be a glane e troas evi kaout a ur pur a metalou prizi uzal. Rak pell e mamm diouz ar mare ma vije kavet pez malzen ou aour varen an diouz ar men gleuz. Ar men gleuchou n'in ke mui e lo den deus bue ar pe brasa deus an du de Colorado den de ihiou. Neus lec'h ebet er stad avad, a vije chomet e mezo levezon, a pa vije ar zavadurioù lezet var o lec'h, guir a labour, a lezen ou an transportchou. Ne vije ket Colorado ar pez e c'hiou, ma ne vije ket bet eus labour louz ar mengleuchou.